I'm looking away. I'm looking so sensitive.
And the cute.
Is that like in the wild, if when an animal makes
it is a threat. Okay. I mean, it is, you know, if you're staring at an animal like that, it can be perceived as a threat. Mm-hmm. And again, this is a wild cat. This isn't a domesticated cat. And the big difference is
look at the black ears,
Wendy.
These
guys have instincts, which are survival instincts.
I know, and he's looking at his fur.
Instincts, you know?
Let me ask you, this might be a dumb question.
Yeah, I mean, you'd like
my cat use a litter box. Do these cats, do they bury it when they, after they...
You know, sometimes they will, like, dig a little bit and cover it a little bit, but not, like, bury it.
Stop doing that, you're frightening me.
Yes, he did.
He did, yes, didn't he? Give me the nipple, guys.
All right, there you go. I'm not looking at you, kitty.
But they are also...
And sharp claws, too.
Yeah, very sharp claws, which they use to grab those birds. But what's really cool about these guys is they can also bring down prey that is twice as large as they are.
Isn't
he
cute? Doesn't he remind you of a part, cougar part something else?
They will do the whole big cat jump on... neck bite thing.
Wow.
And bring them down that way. So
now, do they go in packs ever? Do they work two at a time?
They're very solitary.
Okay.
And as a matter of fact, a lot of people would think that they're rare because you see if you go to Africa or, you know, at zoos or on TV, you see a lot of lions and you see, you know, cheetahs and things like that.
Right.
Those, if you were to